friends, so in this video we are gonna learn a concept based on analytic function, where we are gonna find out the value of analytic function when the imaginary part of that function is given. So it means we want to find out the analytic function when only imaginary part is there but real part is not given. So for that, what we'll do is we'll consider one analytic function. So let's consider analytic function w, that is function of z, and we know that it is defined by u of x comma y plus I v of x comma y. So let f of z be the analytic function. Now we have to find out the analytic function, that is f of z, when this v is given, since v is the imaginary part. So there are certain cases in the numericals where you will come across the imaginary part, that is v, would be given, and they will ask you to find out the value of analytic function or analytic function f of z. So in such cases, if u is not given, then how to get the value of f of z? So let's see these steps. So in step number one, we will find out the value of dou v by dou x and dou v by dou y, since v is given, and we get this value of dou v by dou x and dou v by dou y by just partially differentiating v with respect to x and y. After that, we are going to use the identity or the property of analytic function. So according to property of analytic function, if f of z is analytic function, then its derivative f dash of z is given by the formula dou v by dou y plus I dou v by dou x. So this is the formula of f dash of z if f of z is analytic function. Now since it is said that imaginary part of analytic function is given, it means the given function or the function that we are finding is analytic, and hence we can use this property of analytic function. Now whatever value that we got in step number one, we are gonna substitute these two values in step number two, and we are gonna get the value of f dash of z. But let me tell you my friends, that since v is function of x and y, and you are differentiating v with respect to x and y partially, you will get value of f dash of z in terms of x and y, because dou v by dou y and dou v by dou x both are in terms of x and y. Now the question is to get the value of analytic function f of z, and for that we need to integrate this f dash of z with respect to z. And if I'll integrate that f dash of z with respect to z, then I should have that f dash of z in terms of z. Now the question is how to convert this function f dash of z, which is now in terms of x and y, into terms of z. So to convert this f dash of z in terms of z, we have to use something, and that method is called as Milne-Thomson's method. So friends, I am going to apply the Milne-Thomson's method, in which we will convert this f dash of z in terms of z by substituting or by replacing x with z and y by 0 in this f dash of z. So here I'll say apply Milne-Thomson's method. By substituting x as z and y as 0. And once we get the value of f dash of z in terms of z, we are gonna integrate that f dash of z with respect to x, with respect to z. So here I'll say integrating f dash of z with respect to z, and we will get the value of f of z. So friends, we are gonna apply this method which I've just explained you in one numerical. So we have a numerical where the imaginary part of the analytic function is given, which is v equal to x square minus y square plus x upon x square plus y square, and we have to show that the real part u is minus 2xy plus y upon x square plus y square plus c. Now friends, if we want to show that the real part is equal to given value, then first of all we need to find out the value of f of z, that is the analytic function. And from that analytic function, since v is given, f of z we know, we can easily find out du, that is the missing term. Now how to get the value of f of z from v? And for that we are gonna use these steps. So in step number one, we will get the value of dou v by dou x and dou v by dou y by differentiating the v term with respect to x and y partially. So let's start. So here I'll say v is equal to x square minus y square plus x upon x square plus y square. So therefore here we'll get dou v by dou x is equal to 2x, this the derivative of y with respect to x partially will be 0. Next here x we have in numerator and denominator, so we are going to use u by v rule, and according to it we will get in denominator x square plus y square the whole square. Next x square plus y square, the derivative of x, that is 1, minus x as it is, and derivative of x square is 2x and derivative of y square is 0. Next, so here we get the value as 2x, and here we will get minus 2x square, and here x square, so we will get minus x square, y square is positive, so y square as it is, upon x square plus y square the whole square. Similarly, we will get the value of dou v by dou y. So for that, we will differentiate this v with respect to y partially. So derivative of x square is 0, y square is minus 2y. Next plus x is constant outside, and the derivative of this term is minus 1 upon x square plus y square the bracket square into 2y. So here we will get minus 2y minus 2xy upon x square plus y square the whole square. Now after that we will find out the value of f dash of z, which is dou v by dou y plus I dou v by dou x. So for that we'll put these two values in step number two. So we will get so now we got this value of f dash of z, and we got the value of f dash of z in terms of x and y. Now we are going to apply this Mill-Thomson's method to get the value of f dash of z in terms of z, and for that we will substitute x equal to z and y equal to 0 in f dash of z. So here I'll just say by Mill-Thomson method, x is z and y 0, so this would give me f dash of z is equal to y 0, so first term is 0, y 0 this term is also 0, 2 z I y 0, so this term is 0, here I'll get minus z square into I, so minus I z square upon y 0 z square the whole square, that is z raised to 4. So here we would get 2zi minus I upon z square. So now we got the value of f dash of z. So to get the value of f of z, we will follow the last step, that is integrating the f dash of z with respect to z. And for that here I will say integrating both sides with respect to z. So here we would get f of z equal to 2 as it is, I as it is, the integration of z is z square by 2, next minus I as it is, and the integration of 1 upon z square is minus 1 by z plus c. So here by cancelling this 2, and we can take this I common, so we will get z square minus minus plus 1 by z plus c. So here we got the value of f of z. But my friends, if you'll see the question, then here it is given that we have to show that the real part is this. Now here I got the value of f of z, but I should find out the value of real part. So to find out the value of real part, what we'll do is we will again resubstitute z as x plus iy, because z is a complex number, and then we will take real parts together, imaginary parts together, and we'll see whether we are getting the real part, that is u, as the given question or not. So for that I'll put z as x plus iy. So here I'll say put z as x plus iy in f of z. So therefore the value of f of z would be I, in bracket we had z square plus 1 by z, so this will become x plus iy the whole square plus 1 upon x plus iy plus c. So by solving this, here we will get I, the square of the bracket is x square plus 2ixy plus I square y square, where I square is minus 1, but for simplicity I'll keep I square as it is here. Next, this 1 upon x plus iy, we know that it is x minus iy. So here I again use the formula, that is 1 upon x plus iy is equal to x minus iy. So here we will get I, x square is the real term or real part. Here I square is minus 1, so we will get minus y square, which is real. So x square minus y square, and here we will get plus x. Next, in these two terms I can take I common, and here we will get 2xy minus y plus c. So we will put z as x plus iy in f of z. So therefore f of z will become I into x plus iy the whole square plus 1 upon x plus iy. So I into x plus iy the whole square plus 1 upon x plus iy plus c. Now we will simplify these terms. So here we will get I as it is. This will be x square plus 2ixy plus I square y square. So I am applying the formula a plus b the whole square, and here since we have the complex number in the denominator, we will rationalize it. So here we will get 1 upon x plus iy into x minus iy, and at the same time I'll write the same term in the numerator, plus c. So I as it is, this will be x square, and here I square is minus 1, so we will get minus y square. So x square minus y square plus 2ixy. Here we will get x minus iy upon x plus iy into x minus iy is x square plus y square plus c. Now if we'll separately divide each term in the numerator by x square plus y square, then we would get I x square minus y square plus 2ixy plus x upon x square plus y square minus iy upon x square plus y square plus c. Now if we'll take all the real terms together, then we will get x square minus y square plus x upon x square plus y square, and from these two imaginary terms we can take I common, and we will get 2xy minus y upon x square plus y square plus c. Now, we have one more item outside the bracket. So, I'll take this I inside. So, here we will get this real part as imaginary, because we are going to multiply this first term with I, and this second term which has I will become I into I, I square, and that will be converted into real part. So, here we will get is equal to I into x square minus y square plus x upon x square plus y square. Next, this is I into I, I square, that is minus 1. So, we will get minus 2xy minus y upon x square plus y square plus c. Now, if I'll write the real part first, then this will become minus into 2xy, that is minus 2xy. This will become minus minus plus y upon x square plus y square. So, this is the real part, and the imaginary part would be x square minus y square plus x upon x square plus y square plus c. So, here we got the real part and imaginary part of f of z, where the real part is called as u and the imaginary part is called as v. And if you will see the question, then the question was that show that the real part u is minus 2xy plus y upon x square plus y square plus c. Now, if you see here, then we already got the real part as minus 2xy plus y upon x square plus y square and this c. So, here we can say that therefore, real part, that is u, is equal to minus 2xy plus y upon x square plus y square plus c. So, this is the required proof. Thank you.